guys, welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Pragya, aka Glam by Pragya. So if you're new to my channel, hi, hello, please make sure you join my glam squad by hitting that red subscribe button and down below. So if you are someone who has been following me for a while now and has been following me from the beginning of my skincare journey, so you know how bad I reacted when I first time used niacinamide on my skin, and it was a complete disaster. I used for 2 months continuously. Like, I used niacinamide like serum. It was a 10% with 1% zinc niacinamide serum, and I use, if you want to know which one I reacted, I will mention the link over here so you can check that out and what is my thought and opinion about it. So that was the first time I have used niacinamide, and after that I completely stopped because I was reacting so bad. I was purging, and I was so scared to put niacinamide on my skin after that because I was in a trauma that if I apply it again, I'll break out again. It will take me months and months to remove those spots, remove those pigmentation I was having. So it was a complete fail and I was so disappointed. So today, in this video, I am going to be taking that challenge again. I am going to be trying out niacinamide again on 10% niacinamide serum. Now this serum is from Dot & Key. This is the packaging. So I'm going to be showing you clips. I'm going to be talking about how my skin felt with this product. Is it, or is it worth it? Is it not worth it? I am going to be brutal honest over here. And I'm going to be talking about ingredients, fragrance, and every single thing. So yeah, I am super nervous today regarding the product, but without any further ado, let's just get rolling. Coming to the product, it is the Dot & Key Ultimate Spot Corrector 10% Niacinamide Skin Clearing Serum. So it claims that it will clear your skin, first thing. Next, it contains licorice and sunflower seed oil. It claims to visibly fade dark spots and minimize pores while improving skin's all over texture and clarity. It contains 1% of zinc actives with vitamin E and B5. So it is also a glow boosting formula. So whatever this product is claiming, I actually am like super impressed with the claims, but now let's just see what this product does and what are the rest written over in the back over here. So it is said that it is a lightweight non-greasy serum with a blend of niacinamide and zinc. Together they help to retexturize the skin, reduce inflammation, and promote an overall glowing, blemish-free skin. Now as you can see, the packaging looks adorable. I love the yellow color cardboard thing going on. The packaging is 10 on 10, but we need the good product. The product should be good. That's it. That's the main thing. Now, coming to the main ingredients. Now, first thing is that it contains aqua. Second ingredient is niacinamide. I'm happy that it contains niacinamide as a second ingredient because it's a 10% niacinamide serum. Next, it contains dimethicone. It is kind of a silicone, but sometimes silicones are good for your skin because it kind of creates a barrier so that, you know, it kind of protects your skin. So sometimes silicones is good. If you don't know, dimethicone is also there in Pond's moisturizer, in Neutrogena gel based moisturizer, in many serums, in many moisturizers, and then there is hyaluronic acid, which is also, hyaluronic acid is really good for, you know, as working as a humectant, means it will attract moisture towards your skin. Next, it contains pomegranate fruit extract, which is good for giving you that glowy skin. And it also contains perfume and licorice extract and sunflower seed oil, which is at the last two ingredients. Like, licorice and sunflower seed oil is the last two ingredients, and before that there is perfume. So overall, I would say the ingredients are okay, but there is a bit of silicone in the, you know, after the first two ingredients. This is my first time I'm using it. I was super nervous. I was like crazy that whether it will suit me or not, I'm gonna break out or not. It is so lightweight. It is just like water. It has a bit slimy texture to it. The consistency is very runny. It is almost like water. It feels so hydrating when you are applying. It just feels that your skin is drinking glasses and glasses of water. I can really feel like this is giving me the hydration. Can you just see how my skin looks nourished and smooth, and like it feels like my skin is really drinking up the serum. I can say that it absorbs quickly, so there is no tacky feel, no sticky feel. It just gives you a very nice glow, and I totally agree with what Dot & Key claims. It is actually a very lightweight formula, and it is actually non-greasy. I will let you know whether I am purging or not, so stay tuned. So this is after 2 days now. This is the time I am actually noticing no breakouts. Guys, like, coming to the main claim, that whether it actually removes spots or not. It is not like clear, but it did clear a lot of my skin imperfections. Like, I will show you a picture side by side. This is like literally 1 month ago, and this is my skin right now. Like, can you see the slight fade in my skin? Brown spots and like discolorations of, like, those are actually my acne marks, like those spots. And can you just see how much it has removed, like the discoloration? Now I actually layer up my niacinamide really well. I use other products also. So even Dot & Key mentioned that this product will take you up to 8 weeks to actually see visible results, so almost 2 months. Now coming to the next part, is that how to layer your niacinamide serum to your skin. So here is the clip where I'm actually showing my morning skincare routine before sitting for this video, how I really like to prep up my skin. I go ahead with the Cosrx Snail Mucin. It is an essence. So after that, I take the Dot & Key Niacinamide Ultimate Spot Corrector. In a very light tapping motion, I really tap that product into my skin. So after that, I really like to go ahead with a moisturizer. For moisturizer, I'm using the Dot & Key Hyaluronic Serum. This is also, again, a very good moisturizer. But yes, if you are a dry skin girl, then I would say you should go ahead with a good moisturizer, a cream based moisturizer, because the serums won't be enough for you. The way I prep up my skin in morning, so that's what I exactly do. I will 100% recommend to you guys. And also I would like to say that do a patch test before you try it out. And if you are someone who broke out with niacinamide previously, try this one out. You will not regret, I feel so. But it has a little bit of fragrance, but it is something not you will feel like, oh my god, it is so fragrant, I'm choking. No, it will not feel like. I have seen so many people like are saying that, oh, the fragrance is so loud, it's like making me feel like choke. No, it's not like that. But yes, I would like to say the hyaluronic acid serum has a little bit more fragrance to it. I feel the power of the fragrance over there is a bit more, but I don't feel their products have very high fragrance to it. It has fragrance, like normal one, like how other products, other skincare products also have, like other high-end skincare products also have fragrance. It also have fragrance just like that, and it is not making me break out, and it is making my skin feel good. So yes to this product. So yeah, that's it. Let's wrap it up for today's, and we'll see you guys in my next video. Till then, bye bye, see ya, take care, love you.